Hello students, in this video lecture we will study our first chapter, chapter 1, Introduction to Data Structure and Algorithm Analysis. In this lecture we will study first basic concept of data structure and algorithm analysis, then need of data structures, then advantages and disadvantages of data structure. After that, different definitions like data, data types and data objects, then different types of data structures. What do you mean by data structure? Actually, the data structure and algorithm are interrelated with each other. The term data structure is used to describe the way data is stored, and the term algorithm is used to describe the way data is processed. To develop a program of an algorithm, we should select an appropriate data structure for that algorithm. Therefore, program is equals to algorithm plus data structure, and data structure is represented as data structure is equals to organized data plus allowed operations. In simple term, data structure can be defined as a representation of data along with its associated operations. Data structure is a way of organizing and storing data in a computer system so that it can be used efficiently. Next topic is need of data structure. As we know that the requirement of users with respect to data processing are also becoming complex and large. To solve such a complex and large problems, the basic data types provided by programming language are not enough. Thus, there is a need for data structures, which gives more structure to data. These data structures may be a combination or collection of the basic data types with their own properties and operations. First, data structures are especially important when we have a large amount of information and data. Various operations like insertion, deletion, traversing, searching, sorting can be performed easily as data is well organized and accessible with help of data structure. Third, by choosing the appropriate data structure, we can improve our program efficiency, means, or we can say the effective use of principles of data structure increase efficiency of algorithms to solve problems like searching, sorting, and so on. A data structure helps us to understand the relationship of one data element with the other. Let us see one example. Let us consider two ways of the data organization in the directory. For example, data is phone numbers and names. First condition is, if the data is organized randomly, then to search a person by name, one has to linearly start from first name till the last name in the directory. And the second way, if the data is organized by sorting on names alphabetically, then the search is much easier. This is the importance of data structures. Advantages of data structure. Data structure allows easier processing of data. It allows information stored on disk very efficiently. Third is, a variety of operation can be performed on structured data, means sorting, searching, traversing, like this. We can access knowledge anytime and any place. Fifth advantage is, it is secure means of storage of information. And sixth advantage is, better algorithm can be used on organized data, which improves the program efficiency. Here, the list of areas in which data structure are applied extensively. First is in compiler design, in operating system, in database management system, in graphics program, and artificial intelligence. And in this section, we will study common definition used in data structures. First definition is data. Actually, a data plays an important role in programming. All computer programs deal with data input, data processing, and data output. Data is raw, unprocessed input given to a system. Then the next term is information. Information is a set of data which is processed in a meaningful way according to the given requirement. When data is processed, it becomes an information. In short, meaningful, logical, and processed data is called as information. Information can be defined as meaningful data or processed data, or we can say the processed data is known as information. Data can be of two types. First is atomic data and second is composite data. Composite data is also called as a non-atomic data. First, we will see atomic data. Atomic data is a single or a non-decomposable entity. For example, an integer 10 or the character A. And then second is the composite data. Composite data, a data that we can be broken into subfields that have meaning is called composite data. For example, the telephone number consists of subfields like country code, city code, and telephone number. Data is collected from different sources. It is collected for different purpose. Data may consist of numbers, characters, symbols, or pictures. Next definition is data type. Data type is a term used to describe the information type that can be processed by computer and which is supported by programming language. Means what? A data type determines the value that variable can take and the operations that can be performed on that variables. A data type is collection of values along with set of operation defined on those values. Hence, we can define a data type as the set or collection of values that the set of operations that operate on those values. There are three types of data type. First is simple data type, second is derived data type, and the third is user defined data type. Let us see first data type, simple data type. A simple data type means it is also called as a built-in data types. The data types provided by programming language are known as simple data types or the built-in data types. The variables of this data type can hold only one value of that type. For example, integer, character, float are the simple data types in C. Next data type is derived data type. Derived data type means what? These types are derived or constructed from the basic data types, or we can say that derived data types are the data types that are derived from primitive data types. The C language provides derived types such as arrays, pointers, and so on. Arrays means what? Assign a single name to whole group, that is the homogeneous group. Means for example, integer A of 10. And next is the pointer. Pointer means what? A pointer is memory location that holds a memory address. Pointers are more efficient in handling complex data structure and the tables. And the third data type is user defined data types. User defined data types means what? These data types are created by programmer. Those data types which are defined by the users as per his or her requirement are called as a user defined data types. Some common user defined data types are enum, structure, union, and so on. Third definition is data object. Data object are the entities that actually contain the information. Data object refers to a set of elements, say D, of a specific data type, which may be finite or infinite. For example, a data object alphabet is defined as D is equals to A, B, C dash dash up to the Z. This is the finite data set. And infinite data set means what? That is plus 1, plus 2, or the minus 1, minus 2, dash dash up to the infinitely. Next definition is ADT. ADT means abstract data type. And abstract data type is a specification of logical and mathematical properties of a data type or structure. Nowadays, applications require handling of special kind of data. The built-in data types may not be able to satisfy the requirement for handling such a special data. Hence, the programmer may have to create and implement his own data type to suit the program requirements. Programmer has to decide what to store, what operations to perform, and what should rules to be followed. This is done by first specifying ADT. ADT only gives the logical properties and operation of the data type without giving any details about the implementation. It simply tells us what has to be done. It does not tell how to do it. ADT does not tell how to store element of data object, how to perform the operations, how to enforce the rules while performing the operations. The ADT is a useful tool for specifying the logical properties of data type without going into any details. In simple terms, a data type is a collection of values and set of operations on those values. Last definition is data structure. Data structure is a way of collecting and organizing data in such a way that we can perform operation on this data in an efficient way. A data structure is defined as a set of domain D. A design domain belongs to data object, that is capital D. A set of functions F and a set of axioms A. The triple DFA denotes the data structure D, and it will be usually have written as D, where capital D means domain, it denotes the data object. Then function F, it denotes the set of operations that can be carried out on the data objects. And axioms, that is A, it denotes the properties and rules of the operations. This is called as the triple DFA. About definition is also called as abstract data type, that is ADT. Implementation details of an ADT are hidden. That's why it is called abstract. We can classify data structure into various types. First type is logical and physical data structure. Second is primitive and non-primitive data structure. Third is linear and non-linear data structure. Fourth, static and dynamic data structure. And fifth is sequential organization and linked organization. Let us see one by one types of data structure. First data structure is logical and physical data structure. First, logical data structure. The ADT specifies the logical properties of the data type. It is just a mathematical or abstract concept which defines the data type. Means suppose, for example, let us take an array. means the logical relationship or the logical representation of array is the data type is integer. Integer. Suppose array name is a and a of 10. Then what is the logical structure of this array a is? That is just suppose array 10, but we consider for the 5 elements. Means 1, 2, 3 and the 4th and 5th. Then on 0th index, first element is stored on first index. Second element will be stored on second index. Third element will store and so on. This is the logical structure of data or the array. Then next is the physical data structure. In physical data structure, that is how the data object have to be represented in computer memory so that their logical relationship is maintained and operation can be performed on them. This is our physical data structure. Then let us see same example for the array, but for the physical structure. Means, as we know, the integer required 2 bytes. Okay. Then, if we say the first element is stored on address 1020, then the next element is stored on address 1022. As we know, the integer data type required 2 bytes. Then third element is stored on 1024. A fourth element is stored on 1026 and so on. This is as in this way we know that the representation of array in computer memory. This is our physical data structure. Next data structures type is primitive data structures and non-primitive data structures. A primitive data types defines how the data will be internally represented in, stored and retrieved from the memory. Primitive data types are basic data type of any language. Data objects are atomics, that is, they consist of a single unit of information and do not contain any subparts. Internal representation of data object is fixed for a specific machine or may vary from one to another. Examples of primitive data structures are integer, float, characters and pointers. The pointers don't hold a data value. They hold memory address of the data element. Therefore, pointers are also called as reference data types. We consider the primitive data structures as integer. Suppose data type is integer, variable name is n, and value assigned to this variable is 10. Then internal memory representation of this n is variable name n, actual value is 10 and the address of this variable is, suppose for example, 2020. This is the primitive data structures. This is the atomic in nature. It stores the only single value. Okay, is that clear? Then second data type is non-primitive data structure. A non-primitive data structure are derived from primitive data structures. They are composite in nature, that is, they are composed of several units of information. This structure is a collection or a group of similar or different data atoms. The examples are arrays, structure, union, and files. Suppose, for example, integer a of 10 means what? The collection of 10 integer numbers. And suppose we consider the second example, that is structure. Structure means what? Suppose example of composite data structure, keyword is struct. Student and the data members for this user defined data type is data type are integer, roll number, and suppose character data type is there. Name, character name 20. This is the combination of more than one data types. Here the hierarchical representation of primitive and non-primitive data structure. First is primitive data structure in this, and then the non-primitive data structure. The example of primitive data structures are integer, character, float, and pointers. And non-primitive data structures examples are arrays, structure, and the union. Next is linear data structure and non-linear data structure. Linear data structure means inline. The elements of linear data structure are arranged in a line, that is, they form a sequence or list. There is a ordering, first, second, and so on. Mapping is one-dimensional. The elements have one-to-one relationship with other elements. The examples of linear data structure is array, stack, queue, and linked list. Means suppose, for example, we consider the linked list. This is the linear data structure. Like this. And here the last node of linked list, that is null. And then next is non-linear data structure. In a non-linear data structure, the elements have a one-to-many relationship between them. The elements don't form specific sequence. For example, trees and graphs. Hierarchical representation of linear and non-linear data structure is, first is linear, then second is non-linear. In linear data structure, the examples are array, linked list, queue, and stack. And in non-linear data structure, graph and tree. Here, the graphical representation of linear data structure and non-linear data structure. In linear data structure, the example is linked list, and in non-linear data structure, the examples are tree and graph. Next data structure type is static data structure and dynamic data structure. A static data structure is one in which the number of data elements remain fixed throughout the application. When number of elements in DS are known in advance, memory for the elements can be allocated in advance, that is during compile time. Size does not change during the entire program. Memory remains allocated even when there are no elements in data structure. For example, array. The next data structure type is dynamic data structure. In dynamic data structure, we cannot predict the number of elements in advance. Some application requires elements are added and deleted dynamically. As data structure grows as elements are added and shrink as elements are deleted. Such data structure are called as a dynamic data structure. For example, stack, queue, and linear. Hierarchical representation of static and dynamic data structure. Array is the example of static data structure, and stack, queue, and linked list are the examples of dynamic data structures. Last data structure type is sequential organization and linked organization. In sequential organization, in this, successive data elements are stored a fixed distance apart. If element AI stored at location LI in memory, then element AI plus 1 will stored at LI plus 1 for some constant C. For example, array. If we take the example of array here, suppose A, if the first element is stored on address 2020, then next element is stored on address 202. If the integer array elements are there, then 30 store on 204. That is sequential organization. Okay. And then next is linked organization. The elements of data structure can be stored at any memory location, but their sequence or order is maintained by linking the element. For example, linked list whose data structure are connected by number of nodes. Suppose if we consider a memory representation of link elements, suppose first element is stored on address 100. Then suppose next element is stored 20. Suppose it is stored on address 404. And the third element, suppose, is stored third on address 8080. Suppose if we consider this example, then how these elements are linked together by using the pointer, means it stores the address of next location. This is after 10, then 20. This is the physical representation or physical data structure, we can say. And logically, we can say that the logical representation of linked list is, suppose first element is stored at or stored on address 100. Then we maintain a pointer for linking of these elements. The next element is stored on address four zero four four, that is 2, and the next element is stored 30. This is our last element, that's why here null on address 8080. This is the linked organization. I hope you understand all these concepts which we studied in this video lecture. Okay, thank you.